Hi everybody, it's Tracy from Cape Breton Regional Library. I'm just going to share one of my favorite recipes with you today. It's cinnamon rolls, and it's very easy. It's relatively inexpensive to make, so let's hope you all enjoy. I have washed my hands already with soap and water, but I think just in these times I'm going to do a little extra cleaning. Okay, so I'm going to start with the dry. Dry ingredients will be 3 cups of flour, 's a good idea to kind of level it off to make sure that you've got a good, you've got a full amount. It's one of my favorite things to make. They're popular at home. Okay, so we've got 3 cups of flour, 3 teaspoons or 1 tablespoon of baking powder. One teaspoon of salt. And 1/2 cup of brown sugar. That's the special ingredient. Whenever you measure brown sugar, you want to pack it rather than just leveling off like we did with the flour. So that's the full 1/2 cup. So that's all your dry, which you're going to want to mix together. And just give it a quick mix, nothing too fancy. This is a great recipe to do with kids too, because kids like to cook and like to bake, because they just get right in there, and it's a good way to spend a little time together too. Okay, so I've got the dry ingredients. We're going to use 1 cup of margarine. Now, I love to use the ones that are already measured for you. They're in blocks. So each of these is 1/2 cup to give you your full cup of butter. And I do tend to use margarine as opposed to butter because it's a little more inexpensive than baking with butter. So we're going to cut it in, which basically just means you are kind of mashing in your cup of butter. Now I start out with the fork, but honestly, at home, you're cooking for yourself, you're cooking for your family, you can get right in there. Hands are clean, so we're all good. What you're looking for is like a pea-sized mixture. So we want all that butter incorporated with the dry ingredients. And once you've done that, there's only really one more ingredient. And that's 1 cup of milk. Now, I'm just going to show you what I did, is you make a well in the center, like this, and that just means like a little hole. You pour the milk in all at one time, and you're going to stir from the outside in, and that just helps everything get incorporated quickly and easily. So mix it all around. Now again, once you've got it kind of semi-incorporated, this is another instance where I get right in there. I don't have any rings on that have stones in them. I've done a wash with soap and water plus the hand sanitizer. I have my hair up today too. If you have long hair, you want to have your hair up when you bake. If you have short hair, you're probably okay. Some people will still use a hairnet, or they'll wear a cap when they're baking or cooking. So we've got it all kind of incorporated. So that's it. It's that easy. So we're going to just set that aside for one sec. Just add that in there. So now we have to flour your board. And the board is just the surface, that whatever surface you're using to roll out whatever it is you're making. So we're going to flour the board. Just move some stuff around for you. Spread it as evenly as you can. Don't worry about the mess now. Baking's not much fun if you're just worried about the mess. You take care of that when you're all finished. So, get that over there. So you take your ball of dough. Give it a good little pat. Okay, and you're gonna lay it out. And you need a rolling pin to roll this recipe out. So, put a little flour on your pin as well. Now, a little tip, rather than rolling in a circle, try to roll the dough out in a big rectangle. So what I tend to do is I just go this way first, give it a little flip, and then you won't have to flip it anymore. You've got flour on the bottom and flour on the top, so nothing's sticking. Move that out of there. So you're going to roll the dough out to about half an inch thickness, maybe a little less. You're going to get that square kind of shape. This shape works better when it comes time to roll them out. And don't be too fussy. Like if you find what you're trying to get, I don't know if you can see that, but what you're trying to get is an even spread. So if they turn out a little thicker, that's okay. But try to get it as even as you can, an even thickness. Okay. So now we're ready for the filling, which is one of the best parts. So to do this, we have about 2 tablespoons of butter, or in this case, margarine. And you melt it. Some people just rub the butter on or the margarine on without melting it, and that's okay too. I like to melt it. I seem to have good luck that way, so don't mess with a good thing. So you just spread that all on. And lots of brown sugar. I typically use a full cup. If you don't like them that sweet, you can use a little less. If you want to use more, that's okay too. So the butter or margarine helps keep everything sticking when you go to roll it. Sometimes I find if you don't melt the butter and you're rubbing it on, it pulls on your dough. So sometimes you get a little tear in your dough, and then it makes it harder to roll it out. Okay, so next is cinnamon. At our place, and when my nephews come to visit, or my nieces, they like lots of cinnamon. Again, you can do this to your liking. And then I kind of mix the two together. Okay, and now we're ready to roll. This can be the tricky part. So I'm going to give you a few tips and hopefully they'll help for you. I tend to make sure that I start slowly. So you roll, you tuck, and stretch it out a little bit. Roll, tuck, and stretch.
You roll it, tuck it, and stretch.
And then once you have a good start, then it goes a little quicker. But I wouldn't worry about that. Take the time that you need to roll it out. Now see, my roll is just a little bit longer than my board. So, you give them a good squeeze, and this is when, it's a very forgiving dough, so this is when you can stretch it, pull it, and I'm tapping in the ends so that you don't end up with an end piece that doesn't have anything in it, right? We want that sugar and cinnamon all the way through. Okay. Just a little wipe up here. So I use a bread knife because it's serrated, but not like a steak knife. So you're gonna get a good cut without tearing your dough apart. So let's go this way. And again, looks messy, but it's gonna be really good. All right, so I cut them, this dough or this recipe gives you roughly a dozen and a half. If you've got a bigger crowd, you wanna stretch it out, you'll literally stretch out your dough to get more cuts. And it's about the width of the knife that we're gonna do. And you know, it's always good to have that little extra flour around. Keep your knife from sticking. I think. Now see, I got a little tear there, but that's okay. It's pretty forgiving dough. I'll just carry on. Now once you get them all cut out, I tend to use the knife to lift them. It helps keep them together. And I like to use a little space in between because they're gonna get big and they're gonna be yummy. Oh my God, they're 3-6. I'm cutting them a little thick, right? So I can stretch them out a little. These are so good just as they are. Some people like them warm with butter on them. My husband loves cream cheese icing with them, and my mother-in-law too. So there's all different ways you can enjoy them. They make a nice base for a fancy dessert too. So all you'd have to do is, once they're baked, I'll put them in the microwave, a little scoop of ice cream, a little drizzle of caramel, a few little pecans, and it makes it a really nice dessert. If you're having company or you want to impress the kids or again, you just tuck it all back in if one of them breaks. Baking's a little bit of art and a little bit of science, I think. So it's all good. Okay, so these are ready to go in the oven. You need a hot oven, so we're looking at about 450 for 15 to 20 minutes, depending on your oven. And take them out and enjoy. So if you like to bake or have never baked before and would like to give it a try, we have lots of great cookbooks and baking books at the library. This is just an example of a few of those. One in particular that I love is Home at 7, Dinner at 8. It's a cookbook, but it has an excellent baking section. So maybe give that one a try.
I hope
Your cinnamon rolls turned out good. Now we just hope that you enjoy them and take good care.